This is Rob, aka Anomaly 682. Today I got a very, very special video for you guys. I got a Mancave / collection update video for you guys. This video has been long awaited and long overdue. The first video that I did was very, very popular with you guys. Got a lot of support, got a lot of views, so I appreciate that. But I can tell you guys right off the bat that this video, this tour is going to blow that completely out of the waters. The funny thing is that I told myself beginning of 2017 that I was going to kind of cut back a little bit on the figures because I just bought a new house and, you know, a lot of new expenses and responsibilities. But make a long story short, 2017 was the absolute best year for me in terms of my collection update, in terms of what I've acquired. And what I've been able to get overall. I don't even know if I'll even be able to max 2017. It was that good. A lot of money spent, but as you guys will see from the video, the money was well spent. As you guys know, as you guys may or may not know, again, I'm primarily into the 1/6 horror, and that's what I like, that's what I do. And one thing I want to put out there again is that I've been collecting for over 20 years. 1/6 has been about 3.5 years, going on 4 now, so, you know, time's going quick, but I've been in the game for quite some time, and I've always had a love and a passion for horror in general, so I'm proud to this day that, you know, I've stuck to my roots, and that's pretty much what my collection is geared toward. I'm proud of myself because I haven't, you know, been tempted to kind of follow crowds and to kind of, you know, try to collect what the next man's collecting. I've always just stayed true to my heart and my passion. And my collection, what I'm about to show you guys today, is going to reflect that. So I just hope you guys appreciate that. And, you know, again, just stay true to yourself. Collect what you like. Forget about what everyone else thinks. And just do you. And you'll be much better off. And you'll have a lot more enjoyment in this hobby because we spend a lot of time and money in this hobby. So, want to do a couple of shout outs. One shout out to a very good friend of mine's. You know, we butt heads sometimes and we have our issues, but he's my boy. And I'm referring to Joseph Bratton. A lot of what you guys see, a lot of what you guys are going to see in this video today, I would not have if it weren't for him. So he's my dude. And shout out to Stiff Richards. He's my boy. Also, you know, shout out to everyone that's been very supportive. My boy Fred Krueger, Tim Null, Tim Samra, Once Customs, of course, my dude, you know, always making good stuff for me. Mario Nava, and, you know, there's a lot of people that I can do shout outs for, and I'm sorry if I didn't mention your name, but, you know, there's just a lot of good people in this hobby, and I appreciate everyone's support. And so with that being said, let's get cracking. This is a long video. You know, this video is meant for people that kind of just want to sit down on the couch and just, you know, have a little time on your hands. And, you know, if it's too long for you, you know, give it a fast forward. It's all good. I apologize for off the rip. Some of my detofs, especially in the bottoms, are a little dirty, but it's all good. So, and enjoy the video. And please like, comment, subscribe if you haven't already, and we'll see what's good. All right, one.
So quick tour. Not much has changed. Pool table. Everything for the most part is pretty much the same since the last video. For the most part. For the most part, I definitely need to step up my decor game. That's definitely something that I need to do. There's this angle right here. Oh, my shelves look kind of dirty. Here's my detofs. I added another detof. I got 5 right here now. And I'm gonna probably add another one. Because I got some more masks coming soon, and I gotta be able to display them. This area right here is just the area where we got the TV going. And I just need more decor. It's just really, really plain. Got a 5.2 surround sound, dual subs. We're looking okay. Again, just a different angle, different perspective. I'll show you the detox. Guys, a full look. And we'll get into the figures. Look at my 1/6 Freddy's. Got a Beat Metalli Chest of Souls prototype. And you got the body. I got the brain head sculpt from Beat Metalli's version B 32. Again, I've had this figure for years now. Going on 3 years at least. One of my most holiest of grails. The details on that chest. This figure, I know it's kind of gay to say this, but this figure is definitely to the grave. This is an amazing figure. Amazing presence. We got a side angle action going on here. Yeah, you can't go wrong with these two guys. Perspective shot. Beat him in tighties. Freddy's. Okay, so now we have some clowns. I've always been a huge fan of clowns. And right here we got a Rocco head sculpt on a, forgot the outfit. It's an Asian artist, I believe, that did the outfit. These guys right here are, forgot the toy company that made these, but I was very impressed with the paint applications on these guys, and I thought it would just add to the theme of this presentation right here, so I just went with them. And here is my 1/6 Slim. Shout out to Magnus, my dude. Got his little bag right there. And you know, fantastic piece. You know, one. This is a piece by One Customs. And let's get a close up on that. Yeah, really, really nice. Very, very detailed. And got the cocoon, cotton candy cocoon in the background. Love this piece. The moment I laid my eyes on this piece, I knew I wanted it. So let's get a perspective shot and back up. And these are my clowns right here, guys. And this is my One Customs Nomac that I had one do for me about a year ago. Feels like I've had him longer than that, but love this guy, love the movie. Very, very accurate to the movie. Dead on. And this is another One Customs classic. Those boots. And one of the things I really like about this piece was zooming on this. Look at that head sculpt. Crazy details on that. Wow. Again, man, this is a little accessory piece, a little cement thing that he used against Blade to beat him up. Let's get a zoom in. Let's get a zoom in on that mug again. Just really, really well done. And One Customs. No Mac. Let's get a back shot. There's my boy. And here is another classic. Shout out to SSG. Hosted by Stiff Richards, of course. And this is Pumpkin Boy by Rain Man. SSG exclusive. Yeah, head sculpt. Thing is dope. Nice premium bass. Light up Jacqueline. And then we just got a really nice figure. Again, this is by Rain Man. SSG exclusive. See the way in the back? Hope you guys can see that. Let me zoom in on that. SSG exclusive. Ken Pumpkin Boy Rain Man. Dope piece. Dope, dope piece. And another one customs classic. This is my burnt part, Jason Part 7 New Blood figure. You know, I did do a full review on this piece, so I'm not going to go into a whole lot, but for people that are just tuning in that don't know anything about this, this is a one-of-one piece. This is the only burnt Jason that one has done from scratch, from the ground up. And this piece I've had for about almost a year and a half, maybe 2 years, I don't know. But one thing I can say, look at this, head sculpt, wow. What I can say is that this piece is just absolutely amazing. I love it. And it holds up very well, and it's gonna be a great compliment to my other Part 7 that I have on the way. More like a normal Part 7. Again, this is like the end scene. Jason, how he looks, so that's that for you guys. There we go, get some focused. And here we got my one customs Part 8 Jason Takes Manhattan, and my Part 5 Roy. Love both of these pieces. I've had them both for a while. Did a video review on the Part 8 Jason, so you guys already know what this is about, or at least you should know if you've been following my videos. Here's my Roy. Close up of the mug. You know, again, classic one customs piece. Base. Let's get back up. Again, classic. And this is my, we all know what this is. This is my Beetle Metalli 74 Leatherface. As you guys can see. Just recently acquired this piece. I think it's a fantastic piece with really good quality. Let's get a close up of this this bad boy. Look at that. It's really well done. Exceptional details on the chainsaw. Great accessories. Again, nothing crazy, nothing new, but just a lot of dopeness. And here is my Mad Max Immortan Joe. I just recently got this piece. This piece is by artist Adelectus or Palvik. Pavel Valvik. Again, probably butchering his name, but again, just a really nice piece. Lots and lots and lots of details on this one. Horse teeth mask. Commissioned this piece a few months ago. Took about 8 months for this piece to get completed. But again, just all types of details. Full body, not full body sculpting, but definitely has nice sculpting on it. Little vents in the back. Perspective shot. So Emo Angel. Dope piece. There we go. A lot more to go, guys. This is my One Customs Leatherface remake figure. I love the remake movies. I think they're gritty. I think they're scary, legit. And I like the look. I mean, the writing of the movies aren't that great, but I mean, it's just a dark, gritty movie. I like that. You know, lots of details on this one right here. Lots of details. Great weathering, blood work by the man himself. Yeah, it's a quick glimpse. Remake Leatherface. This guy needs no introduction. Beta Metallis Pry 3 Jason. This is just a figure, guys, for the most part. This is not the full set. I wasn't fortunate enough to grab the full set, but I am fortunate to be able to have what I have, which is the head and the spear gun and the figure, primarily. It's the most important thing. And maybe at some point I can pick up the full figure. But again, we all know what this is. We've seen this before. This is nothing new. Love the way this figure is built, though. So well built. Perspective shot on it. Beat him with Tally Part 3, Jason, love it. Alrighty, and here we go. It's my Jason Goes to Hell and my Toxie. Toxie from Beat him with Tally, we all know that. I got this rather recently. Got a lot of pieces rather recently. And it's a dope piece. It's I think it's a prototype, one of six. And I'm glad to have it. And this is my shout out to JMD. This is my part 9 Jason Goes to Hell with an amazing head sculpt. Absolutely love it. Great figure all around. Not too many of these were made, so this is definitely a keeper. At least until I see something better, which I don't anticipate seeing for a while, because this head sculpt is not easy. Few people have tackled it, and you know, it's just not an easy head sculpt. So some zooming, focus going, and these are my Toxie and my Jason Goes to Hell. So this is again another One Customs classic. It's gonna be the kind of the theme of this video is my 1/6 Tar Man. By One Customs. Now, correct me if I'm wrong, but I don't think he made too many of these. And this, I mean, just Tarman in general, but particularly like this. This one is built on the 1/6 skeleton. Look at the beautiful artwork on this base here, side by one. Got the split dog action here. Yeah, got brain fragments and stuff. Apologize, some of my detox need to be cleaned up, but yeah, so he built this off of a 1/6 skeleton. I think this is the only one he did like that, and I like this particular style in which he did it, because it just adds an extra level of realism to the piece. Love it to death. Back up. Alrighty. This is my Rain Man Psycho DX set. Again, we all know what this is. I don't know what the deal is with this set. For some reason, a lot of people seem to like the set. I like it. You know, I've been wanting this figure for over 20 years. When I started collecting 7-inch figures almost 20 years ago, back in 99, I think. I've been wanting a Norman Bates, and I think this is perfect. Especially now that I got the mother too. That's just the icing on the cake for me. Beautiful, beautiful set. This is definitely a keeper, and will be staying in the collection forever to the grave shit with this. I know that sounds gay, but who cares? And here we go. This is Rain Man, Elephant Man. This is a really cool piece, really good movie. I don't know if anyone's ever seen it, but it's really, really good. Kind of sad and fucked up, honestly, but excellent piece by Rain Man. I don't have the full set, obviously, but this is the one I really wanted, primarily. Look at that head. Face only a mother could love. Ooh. And as my Reagan, version one. Again, I don't have the full set of a lot of these pieces, man, because these shits are fucking expensive, but, you know, I'm just glad that I got in on the figure. So, here she is. Got the pillow and the blanket, though. And love it, man. Great movie. Classic. Let's see if we can get a zoom in on that face. This is a classic, classic, classic movie. If you haven't seen this movie, you have been living under a rock, my friend. So get the fuck out. Just kidding. Yep, so I'm gonna take it back. Here we go. My two beloved Rain Man pieces. And here is a closer look at my Deborah 2.0 dream sequence for Rob Zombie Halloween 2. Had this piece for a while now, so you guys have seen this piece, but this piece is it's just stellar. It's just an amazingly accurate, well done. Put a little close up on that head, the detail there. See how this bad boy looks on the side. Such a nice piece. Again, Deborah 2.0. Let's get a perspective shot. Let's move on. And here is another Jason for you Jason fanatics. This is my Beetle Metalli Part 4 Jason. Again, another piece that just doesn't get the love that it deserves, in my opinion. But that's okay, because all that matters is that I like it. Great movie, too. This was actually one of the last films where they started, just before they started toning everything down and getting really gay and goofy, in my opinion. But Beetle Metalli definitely could have included more with this release. That's why I think a lot of people kind of hated on it, but hey, it's still a great figure. Definitely. Hard as fuck to pose this thing, though. It took me weeks to get a good pose that I liked with this guy, because the joints are stiff. But it's all good. There we go. Alrighty, so here is my mask collection. I have just four masks, and let's go over what they are, shall we? Alrighty then, quick look. My Connor DeLess. Here is my Delatory half mask from Rob Zombie's Halloween 2. Again, just amazing details on this mask. Look at that. You know, custom shell, custom painted, different artists. Impeccable details. Really, really nice. Here's my Connor DeLess Pretty Woman mask. Version 3. Highly sought after mask in the mask world. Nickelodeon made about 20 of them worldwide. Look at this bad boy. It's my other Connor DeLess. 74 Leatherface. Best in the business, man. Look at the hardware in that mouth. Got staples, stitches, blood work, just some amazing wig, hair work. Stunning. Here is my dilatory dream sequence. Ask. Sign knife by cast and crew. Entire cast and crew. And just dream sequence, one of my favorite masks. Probably my favorite one out of all of them. I like them all, but I just something about this mask that I really like. So nice. And there is my Child's Play 2. One of one doll. From artist. Actually, I can't remember who this is from. This doll in particular is from Technoc Art, based out of Spain. Let's get a close up on it. Real glass eye, porcelain teeth. And this is my V3 from Technoc Art. Based off the Child's Play 3 movie. And he's holding my Burn Chucky V1. Again, very detailed piece. One of one. This is a private commission. Glass eyes, porcelain teeth. Weathered and tattered to perfection, and all private custom commissions. And this is my game room. Got some additional figures. I got some arcade machines. You guys know how I do the arcade machines, so. You know. And this is just, again, same thing. Nothing's really changed, slightly rearranged. Stones and some of my mass-produced stuff. You know, my Freddy. Nothing too crazy. Just childhood shit, childhood nostalgia. Tough. Right here, just a quick look. A couple of Hot Toys stuff. Breaking Bad set over here. And just, you know, I don't have a whole lot of Hot Toys, and I did a lot of liquidating, but some of the stuff for me is just straight childhood, so I hold on to it. That's it. My Screamware. Part 4 bust, very detailed, highly accurate mask, and it's just awesome, awesome. I did a video on this as well, so all the details, I can't remember exactly who did the mask. I think the mask is Screamware, I mean the bust, and the mask is, can't remember, but it's just an amazing mask. Very, very movie accurate. It's my bust. Part 4, Jason. One of the best Friday the 13th movies, in my opinion. It was just, the kills in that movie were just really, really good. And they didn't do a whole lot of editing. They showed everything. There you go. It's my bust. Another figure that doesn't require any type of introduction is prototype of Myers. Shout out to Joseph Branton. We all know what this is, so really no need to go too crazy here. big fan of the movie. I know a lot of people don't like the movie, but I'm a huge, huge fan of the movie. So, gotta have the piece. Got the COA in the background. Beat a Metalli pumpkin. I have some additional head sculpts here. And the tombstone, of course. Again, one of my most beloved figures that I have in my collection. Perspective shot. Just all around masterpiece. Absolute stellar piece. One custom, baby. And here we go again with Concept Myers version 2, V2. I've done a review on this figure as well. Again, nothing really. Here's another concept head that has nothing to do with it. It's just a separate head concept, though. One thing I really like about this piece, even to this day, is the head sculpt. I mean, it's just a really cool custom, but the head sculpt, it's just really, really detailed. The detail in that head sculpt. Still one of my favorite concept pieces that I own in my collection. Concept Myers V2. Again, another classic piece. This is Yunsil, Silent Surfer, Myers. Unfortunately, we're seeing a lot of these clothing runs. I mean, the coveralls are fantastic, but you know, the market's very saturated. But even with all that saturation, this Myers is done right. You have the Yunsil coveralls, Madbug V2 head, which is a very rare head nowadays because the mold's destroyed. Actual Hot Toys boots, Bruce Banner body, Fergo knife. So it is the real deal, but you know, it's a classic piece. And here is some other concept Myers that I have. These rags, or whatever you see that's on the figures, or the figure to the left, came with my Haddonfield set, but I threw it on my V1 concept, and I think it looks absolutely amazing. And this is just a sheet weathered and bloody with the outline of, as if someone's in there, but no one's really in there. Look at the details here, though. Amazing detail. Great sculpt, great concept. And I mean, at this point, I'm just trying to simply display stuff that you typically don't see. And to this day, one of my favorite pieces I have. Here's my Haddonfield piece. This is a concept as well by yours truly, One's Custom. This set came with so much. Came with like 3 head sculpts, the Boo face, which is on him right now, and a few other key items that, you know, the sheets, this awesome head sculpt right here as well. This amazing base. Again, shout out Joseph Bren. You know why. And I got, again, I'm rocking the Blue Face head sculpt. And here's my H1 Rob Zombie Myers with the full metal commission knife. Again, piece that I've shown before. This is actually the remake, H1 remake. And I purchased the head sculpt. This is the original head sculpt right here, but then I purchased this head sculpt and separately, and just do that. I want to give it the classic look. But great piece. and waiting for my my escape Myers, which is on commission right now. Beautiful. And this is my One Customs H6 Fabulous set in collaboration with Tanelia. She did the coveralls, custom fat suit, she did the weapons. I like this piece a lot. Look at that. I'm not a big fan of the movie, but that bass, a little work. Just a really, really good piece. Let's get a zoom in on great hair work, great details in general. He did 40s, so four of them in the world, two bloody, two clean. I got the bloody one, you know, you guys know how I do it. So again, let's get a quick look at that axe. Again, love this piece. Get a perspective shot. And that's him.